welcome to the production that you could have done, but God decided it needed one more generation of perfection. And so these are your genes combined for worship and praise of our God. We thank you that you're here tonight. The video that you saw was put on by the, as it says in your bulletin, the Young Artists in Technical Production. There are about 120 artists that are doing dance and music and technical training and visual arts and acting and songwriting and photography. The video we just saw, as I said, was created by the Tech Kids. But all week long, they've been learning about Christ as the bridge between heaven and earth, the bridge between neighbor and neighbor, and therefore the great commandment, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind and strength, and your neighbor as yourself. And that's how they are being trained to respond. Let me just say this. Later on, we're going to be taking up an offering for the sake of some of our neighbors. It's going to be tilted toward trauma healing. God is not just a God of salvation. He's a God of healing. And we have just gone through one of the most traumatic experiences in the history of the country, let alone the city. And so the offerings you give tonight will be dedicated to training people to help people through trauma in Central Florida. Now let me say this. It is so great you're here tonight. I'm teaching a whole series on discovering your spiritual gifts and how that requires other people. You know the first stage of that? It's for moms and dads and grandparents and aunts and uncles and friends to look at their kid and say, you were wonderful. God's given you a gift. This was such a great night. Thank you. It's for that kind of encouragement, and that plants in their mind then, from the people they love and respect the most, God has gifted me to give to others. Later on, they will identify how He specifically spiritually gifted them. But it starts here as the beginning. I remember early in my ministry, I was preaching a revival in northern Indiana. It was so cold, it was snowing. This little girl walks in, just this little fur around her face. And she just looked like a little angel. I said, you are so beautiful. And she looked up at me, she said, I know. She said, my mama thinks I'm darling. I wish I could have shown you the confidence that little girl had. Because she had a mom and a dad that encouraged her. And so thank you for being here tonight, because that's exactly what you're doing. Let me pray, and then I'm going to introduce something else, another video. Lord, thank you for our kids. These are church kids. They're all of our kids, but yet each one of them has somebody special here that knows them and loves them and wants to encourage them to become the kind of person that you intended when you knit them together in their mother's womb. And so we thank you, and we just ask your blessing upon this time and upon these kids. In Jesus' name, amen. Now let's see what the kids, these young artists, have been learning this week. Watch this.
Hey, Max, you're back.
Yeah, I'm so excited. And what are we doing this year?
The bridge. Well, not an actual bridge. It's about how Jesus is the bridge between us and God.
Huh. Hey, Max, do you know what classes you have?
Visual arts.
That sounds really fun. Do you know what you're doing?
Well, I heard we're doing something like representational art.
Wait, what? What is representational art?
It's like images that sort of look what it's supposed to.
That makes sense.
Is it time for worship?
Come on. Art today.
We made an abstract bridge too. We layered 2D images to make a low relief bridge.
Did you guys get into the non-representational art today? Maybe you'll do that tomorrow.
What is that anyway?
Well, you'll be making sculptures of bridges influenced by shapes and imagery, but they'll no longer represent real bridges.
I can't wait!
Bridge.
That doesn't look anything like a bridge.
That's exactly what non-representational art's all about. See, it's inspired by the concept of a bridge, but it doesn't have to look like a bridge.
It's so cool.
I love this stuff.
Hey, great job this week, guys.
This week was awesome.
I can't believe how many different bridges we made.
I never really thought of Jesus being a bridge, but he is.
Yeah, this week was awesome.
Not again.
What's up, Anna?
My grandma just texted me. I missed Father's Day again.
So you didn't get him anything?
Nope.
Whoa, not even a card?
I know, right?
I hate Father's Day.
Why?
It just reminds me that my dad's not here.
Well, at least you saved money on a card. Hey, Alex, are you crying?
No.
What's up?
Nothing. It's just, my dad moved out of state. I can't get a ride to see him, and Mom says I can't fly alone, so I just don't get to see him. That's just the way it is.
Hey, Jeff, look, we're almost to the bridge.
Cool, the concert is just on the other side.
Hey, Ellie, you don't look so good.
You okay?
Jeff.
What?
Jeffia.
What?
Jeffirophobia.
What?
The fear of bridges.
For real?
Oh yeah, I've heard of that. It's the fear that a bridge isn't built very well.
Jeff.
So you're afraid it's gonna collapse while you're crossing it?
Jeff.
And you get lightheaded, dizzy, and your heart races. It's like you feel really trapped.
Jeff, come on.
Oh, sorry, Ellie.
Don't worry, Ellie. We'll go over the bridge together, and we'll be totally safe.
Yeah, but will we?
Sure, people have been crossing this bridge for years. It's totally safe.
Yeah, but is it?
Ellie, I'm sure the builders of the bridge knew exactly what they were doing.
Yeah, but did they?
Come on, Ellie. This is the only way to get to the Worship in the Arts concert.
I know, I'm just really afraid.
Of what?
Ellie, come on, it's really safe.
I'm just afraid that that's not true.
Hey, do you need some help with that?
That would be great.
So where do you want it?
Let's put it right here.
Does this need to move too?
Yep, let's put it right here.
What's this for anyway?
I'm making a video for YouTube. I hope it goes viral. It's to show how the cross is like a bridge.
Dude, that is epic.
I don't get it.
Do you need any more help?
Actually, I could use everybody's help. Todd, will you be God?
Sure.
Josh, will you be Jesus?
Swag.
And Hannah and Steve, will you guys be Adam and Eve?
Sure.
All right.
Oh, and Josh, will you video this first part?
Sure.
And Todd, you can get on this box.
On it?
On it.
Got it.
Good. So Todd here stands for God the Father in heaven. After God made the world, he decided to make people. Hannah and Steve, you guys get on the box with Todd.
On it?
On it.
Got it.
Good. So God, Adam, and Eve were all together in the Garden of Eden, and it was perfect. But one day...
They sinned.
We sinned.
Tell them what sin is.
Sin is doing wrong in God's eyes.
Right. So that happened. But God stays 100% perfect.
God is so legit.
Yeah. So he can't even be near sin. He had to send Adam and Eve out of the garden. You guys go get on the other box.
On it?
On it.
Got it.
Good. It was like they were on two different cliffs.
With a deep, dark sea in between.
With absolutely no way to get back to God.
Right. So God sent away. Josh, get the cross.
Oh, here, hold this.
God sent his son to make a way for us to get back to God. Put the cross on the sea of sin.
Okay. On it?
On it.
Got it.
Good. He gave his life on the cross to pay for everyone's sins.
So that anyone who trusts Jesus as the way can have eternal life with him.
That's life forever, close with God.
Right. So Hannah and Steve, you guys trust Jesus and take his hand to help you as you walk on the cross.
On it?
On it.
Got it.
Good. God gives eternal life to all who trust in his son.
And we get it when we get to heaven, right?
No, eternal life is here on earth and in heaven.
Oh.
So Todd, reach down and help them get back on their box.
On it?
On it!
Got it.
Good.
Ago, there lived a woodworker king. With splinters and a scepter and sawdust on his throne, his kingdom was beautiful, and he himself was perfect in every way. One day full of love and life and inspiration, he picked up his tools and he began to create.
Revelation 4:2-8. At once I was in the Spirit, and there before me was a throne in heaven with someone sitting on it. A rainbow that shone like an emerald encircled the throne.
Surrounding the throne were 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders.
They were dressed in white and had crowns of gold on their heads.
From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumblings, and peals of thunder. Also before the throne, there was what looked like a sea of glass clear as crystal.
In the center, around the throne, were four living creatures. Each had six wings and was covered with eyes all around, even under its wings. Day and night, they never stopped saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come."
I see a rainbow.
Now when the woodworker king had finished, he took a step back and admired all that he had done. Like him, it was perfect in every way. We were that creation. We were his masterpiece made in his image. He loved his creation so passionately that he breathed life into us, and he called us his own. everything the woodworker king gave. We wanted more. We turned our backs on him and we walked out into the night. Returning to our Creator, but the rains made it impossible to turn back. Thank you.
They tell me that I can't get up. They tell me that I can't get out. They tell me it's just the way it is. I'm trying but I can't get up. I'm crying but I can't get out. They tell me it's just the way it is. It's true, but I'm trying out, no one cares. And I'm crying out, but no one's there. And they're telling me,
nobody's coming for you.
I need a savior.
Take me away. Go along the way. You're with me all the way.
And I will never be alone, for you will never let me go along the way. You're with me all the way. And I am never on my own, for I am never far from home along the way. All along, you're with me all the way. All along the way.
Our gospel was born out of pain and trauma. What we have been through as a community this week is a reminder of the brokenness that Jesus was sent to heal. As a matter of fact, when he read his job description, which is now our job description, he stood up in the synagogue, and this is part of what he said. He has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, recovery of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised. Tonight's offering, and you can respond in three ways. You can write a check to the American Bible Society, or you can respond with cash as the buckets are passed, or you can text it. But tonight's offering will go for that kind of healing, because Christ is the bridge that addresses the brokenness of the world. I want us to understand that the kids that are so marvelous tonight are being taught that it's not just about performance, it's about giving. It's not just about how you are doing, it's about how the people around you are doing and how you're responding to that. So let me pray a prayer of dedication to this offering. And I will invite those of you who are going to pass the buckets to do that at the end of this prayer. And then if you're not prepared to give quite yet, you can write a check and drop it in an offering box. I'm winging this. But just earmark it for the American Bible Society and we'll know where it goes, okay? Pray with me. Lord Jesus, you bridged a great chasm and you experienced great pain, so that by your stripes we could be healed. You were bruised for our iniquities. Help us to sacrificially give so that others might be healed while we celebrate what you've given us. Help us to know that it's so that we can give to others. We pray this in your name. Amen.
Thank you.
wrapping his arms around us, he carried us, his masterpiece, across the bridge. Over the emptiness and fear, over everything that would come in between, back to his kingdom, placing us next to him as he sat on a sawdust-covered throne.
Let's
talent? Can you believe the talent in these kids? I was gonna say something like every year gets better. This was Broadway stuff. This is just unbelievable. And here's the deal. Before I let you go get your kids, and I will let you get your kids, because any kid that's left over, I have to babysit for, and it's not pretty when I do. The unbelievable thing about this is not only did they just do this in a week, basically today, but that they had the kind of coaching and the kind of caring that they did. You know, when Eleanor and Rob create genius like they have here, it takes a whole staff of people working together to really bring out the giftedness that God put into your kids. And so I don't want you just to go out in the foyer, and I do want you to go out in the foyer, and I want you just to gush over the visual arts out there, because they're gush-worthy. And gush over the kids. But anytime you see an adult, or what looks like an adult, wearing a shirt that looks like they've been helping, thank them, please. Thank them. They are the developer of your kids, and there's no more important role next to yours than that. So let me tell you how this is going to go. Bring out the back of your program. In the back of your program, you already noticed that your kid is in a group with a number. Find the number in the back of the sanctuary. We'll have numbers. It'll be lit up in the back of the sanctuary, and you'll find your kid. All right? And then visit the art gallery and the songwriting listening lab. All right? All right. Everybody stand up. I'm going to give a benediction. I'm going to just pray. God, we cannot thank you enough for the gifts you've put into these kids and for the people who bring out those gifts to your glory. Help us bear the sobering celebration of watching these kids develop over the years so that we can see how you made the world and are making the world better through them, so that we can see Jesus in them. We pray this in your name. Amen.